Guy, I already forgot the name. Know the name of. What's the host? What's your name?
Patrick.
All right, thank you. This is my very first time ever doing stand-up. It's actually reminding me of the first time I actually had sex. I'm kind of nervous right now. My heart's beating. I'm starting to sweat. I'm only going to be up for 5 minutes. And I'm all alone. So. I moved here from Texas a while back, and interesting, yeah, Texas, I see, Eric.
Texas.
Represent. Texas is not like it's used to, like you used to know it, like people don't ride around in horses, you know, don't have oil wells in the backyard, we don't, you know, wear cowboy hats, some do, but right before we graduated, me and my friends, we decided to take like a road trip to Texas, like a farewell tour, if you will. So we went to Dallas, we saw the skyline there, and, you know, just something we've never seen before. Went to Houston, to the Space Center, you know, the Galleria Mall had the ice skating rink, just, you know, things you never thought you would see in Texas, so. Even like Corpus Christi, Galveston, South Padre Island, they had beaches just like you'd see in Miami, like you'd see in Malibu. People surfing, it's like, wow, like Texas is just very diverse. It's things you never see. And on the way home, we took a shortcut. We were like in the deep woods. And we saw this little restaurant, started getting hungry. And it was called Coffee Cup Cafe. It's a true story. It is. It was called Coffee Cup Cafe. But it was spelled with all K's. And me and my friends, we were really upset. We had seen all these nice things. And we're like, how the fuck do you misspell? We didn't stop to eat there. I doubt the food was good, so. But when I moved here, I started dating, you know, started doing the dating scene in LA, you guys got some beautiful women. I mean, I have to give it to you. I think 97% of you guys say you're models, so. That's just amazing. But I started dating this girl. She actually was a model. I never saw her or anything, but she was a model. And she's got a couple of things like that. All right. All right, so I was dating this girl, and what was good about her, she liked to role play. And I was like, you know, I'm down for that. So one time she was like, let's play a one-night stand. I was just like, okay, like, you know, how is this? How are we gonna do this? She's like, well, let's go to the club, you know, but we'll go in two different cars. I'm not gonna know you, you're not gonna know me. And we'll meet at the club, we'll, you know, exchange information, and I'll go home with you tonight. I was like, all right, I'm winning, let's go. So I got to the club first. I had to wait in line, which is kind of shitty, but she walked up, got straight in, so. This is horrible. Once I got in the club, you know, we kind of made eye contact every now and then. You know, we made it to the bar. She asked me about her drink, which I thought was selfish because I was like, I already know you. I was role playing, you know, I like to act, so I was role playing. I was in the character. I was like, oh, I'll buy you a drink. She wrote her number on the napkin and slid it to me, so then we went about our business. And then after the club let out, you know, I guess she was there with her girlfriend, so I was just waiting for her so I could take her home, and she came out with her girlfriend, and she was just staggering drunk, just like pissing drunk, just. So her friends took her home, and she like left me there like alone at night, looking stupid. So one of the next times we were watching TV at her house, she was like, hey, let's role play. I was like, all right, what are we gonna do now? She was like, let's play burglar. It's like burglar. She's like, yeah. She's like, go outside, you know, and act like you're gonna break in, and just kind of spy on me for a little bit. And when the time is right, just break in and come get me. I was like, all right. So like I said, I did in character. So I got the ski mask. I had all black everything, like Jesus, all black everything. And she was watching TV, so I was like looking in the window in the living room, and I'm kind of making my move. She went to the kitchen, so I went around back with the dining room window. And then she went upstairs, so I climbed on the balcony. I was looking, she started getting undressed. I was like, all right, you know, the time is now. So right when I'm about to break in, her phone rang, and she got on the phone, and I guess it was one of her girlfriends, so I could kind of hear. And I guess she had like relationship issues, but she started talking. And you know, after 15 minutes, I was kind of, you know, still out there, waiting to break in. But I guess it was something severe because she got up and left to go, you know, take care of a girlfriend. And there again I was, alone, at night, looking stupid. So, you know, I got tired of it. But one of the last times we role played, we were coming home from a movie and I was driving. I said, hey, let's role play. She's like, all right, what are we going to do? I was like, let's play Stranger. She's like, Stranger, what's that? I was like, all right, what you're going to do is you're going to get out the car, pull over, and you're going to walk up the road, and you're going to, you know, hitchhike, come around, and, you know, drive back. She's like, all right, I like that. So she got out of the car, I went about half a mile down the road, and I came back, and I was in character, and I saw her. And I drove up, and I just kept driving, because, you know, I was in character, I don't see the hitchhiker. You know, I felt bad, when I looked in the rearview mirror, I laughed, because you know what? She was alone, at night, looking stupid. Thank you very much, guys.